Oh, hey, oh. here to read the laws of members or extending that. Mayor and staff. It's truly a sad day. It's that time in the world clock. We offer sincere condolences to the Bronco organization, their family, the Billet family, and their friends. We also want to show our support for a member of our community, Mr. Bryce Fisk and his family, Derek Cotton, and the remaining players and staff in the hospital. Godspeed in their recovery. And I'll call on Mr. Bryce Fisk to say a few words.
This evening, as we do give our condolences and mourn and show solidarity with Humboldt and the loss, the tragic loss that has happened. I was recently over in Alberta visiting family and friends, and it was at that moment early on Friday evening when I got a text message from the head of the chaplaincy program for the SJHL saying, please pray, there's been a tragic accident. And immediately after that, I received a text message from my father, who's a pastor in Humboldt, saying similar things. And immediately after that, I received text messages from community members and congregation members about the tragic loss. And immediately, your heart starts to think, how many people are impacted? About how many people are hurting? About the connections and the ties and the unity that we have, and how life goes so much beyond hockey, and yet we're united by sport, but also united together in mourning and in understanding of growing with in unity these people who are struggling at this time. One passage that came to mind that we've been asked as we join together. And if you would allow me, I'd like to read the words from Psalm 23, a well-known psalm that is used in many different situations, and one that I believe speaks to the situation that we here are gathering, but so too are people across our province and our country at this very hour, with vigils in many different communities for those who are lost and those who are hurting. So from Psalm 23, it says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalm 23.
I just don't have a whole lot to say. I just know that being a chaplain with Cody and being a former hockey player, and as word spread on Friday night, that there was an accident, and the word got out, you know, that players and people from the hockey community all over Canada, the U.S., the world, are standing in solidarity and standing in prayer for those that have been impacted by this. So just know that we are not alone in our struggle. My condolences, it's just hard to not imagine. And just know that you and we are standing together as a hockey community and people in the United States, my friends, we're standing in solidarity, and we are praying for those families and those that are in the hospital, and we continue to pray for them that they can get better, and they can just heal or be healing that would happen throughout the families and everybody that is, has been impacted.
Dear friends, we realize very quickly how this goes beyond the sport of hockey. And I'm sure many of you, as I did as well, held family closer, a little bit tighter that evening. And we remember those people who are hurting, those families who have lost, those people who are healing. Specifically, this evening we remember the Fisk family, members of our community, people who we know. And we mourn with them for the injuries, and also we will pray and support and reach out to them and to all people, as many people are doing. As Bryce mentioned, across the province, across Canada, the people are standing in unity and remembering. And so we encourage you to join with them as well. In a moment here, we're going to take a moment of silence. Before we do that, I would like to read off the, have you read off the names of those who have deceased, those who have passed. The hurt and the pain that those families and communities are feeling. We honor them with the moment of silence as well. But before we do that, we'll read off the names, and also I will begin with a short prayer. Remember the people who are injured and those who have lost.
Darcy Hogan, head coach and manager of the hockey club. Brady Nance, on the radio, on the stats. Logan Schwartz, captain from Allen, Saskatchewan, 20 year old. Jackson Joseph, forward from Edmonton, Alberta, 20 year old. Adam Harrell, from Darren, Saskatchewan, I'm sorry, I didn't pronounce that right. The youngest member of the squad, 16 years old. Mark Cross, assistant coach, 27 year old. Logan Gillette from Lethbridge, 21 year old. Tyler Lieber, play by play commentator. Jake Beach from Humboldt, Saskatchewan, 19 year old. Stephen Back, defenseman, 21 year old. Logan Hunter from St. Albert, 18 year old. Xavier Lavelle from Saskatoon, 18 year old. Connor Lutman, Slate Lake, Alberta, 21 year old. Glenn Dirksen from Creever. Evan Thomas from Saskatoon, 18 year old. Sash. Logan Lyons lost.
Gracious God, in this moment we come before you with pain and mourning, in unity, in hurt, in understanding there is loss, and in feeling for those who have lost. Heavenly Father, we pray that you will continue to be with us and with all people. In pain, give healing. In grief, give comfort. In loss, bring open arms. In tears, give shoulders to cry on. In injury, give strength. In this tragedy, bring compassion. In feelings of loneliness, may we all show support. In the trauma, bring unity and grace. In the sleeplessness, bring peace. And in all, bring love. Gracious God, today we pray specifically for the community of Humboldt, for the team, for the families, for the community members, the volunteers, for the emergency workers, doctors, nurses, support staff, and all who look to support at this time. We pray for families who are grieving. We pray for friends who feel the loss. We pray for those around our province and our country who are gathered now at this time in unity to show support. And we pray, gracious God, that you will continue to work with healing and comfort at this time. We pray. Amen. this time we will take a moment of silence, at which time we will close with a some music by Charlotte Merriman, and we will continue on with the service. Let us join together in a moment of silence. Please rise.
Thank you. each other and bless one another.
If you would, please join with me in a closing prayer. Gracious God, we thank you once again for the gift of life. We pray that you will be with us as we walk, as we go from here. That for those who are hurting and injured, you will give healing. For those who mourn, that you will give comfort at this time. Gracious God, we pray that you will continue to work in our lives and those lives who have been affected so deeply by this tragic accident. May you continue to work in our world and in our lives that we can love and support, forgive, and show grace in all things. We pray. Amen. At this time, we'll ask Jamie Chester to forge an Eastern Three Cross to pray and support. And also at this time, after Jamie is finished, also feel free to leave as you feel that we can go from here with some level of comfort, but remembering the tragedy that has happened. And so at this time, we'll enjoy the music from Jamie and go from there. Thank you.
Treasures that, and all you feel around the world.